And welcome in my video, How to be a Lighting Artist. So this video, it's very important for my mentoring program because it's one of the skills, like taking care of all the other skills in terms of generalist. So that's like a key skill to have in 3D. So I'm gonna pass on review the job, what you do in the studio, what your responsibilities, what the skills you need. And talk a bit about extra stuff like renderer software and stuff. So lighting artist is mainly the guy like a director of photography, a gaffer or grip guy. He's gonna be the person in charge of placing the light and to choose what light you're gonna use. So what light and where to place them. Obviously it's not the same constraint as a live action show, but you're gonna have this kind of responsibility to put light in the space and to use them to light the scene properly. So you really want to enhance atmosphere, tone, colors, and mood. That's very, very important. That's what you want to add. Depth as well, depth on the scene. Because when you don't have light, it can be super, super flat, and you want to add this kind of depth in your scenes to understand the space, understand what is happening, so to read the scene. Normally, not in every studios, but normally
you're gonna have some color script,
light board, color board, and storyboard as well can help you to understand what is happening and where you're gonna place the light on the scene, and to be careful of the continuity of the show, to of the shot, or the scene, or the sequence, this kind of stuff. So very important to have like a color theory skills, understand the colors very well, to understand what's gonna happen on your scene, composition and stuff like this. The lighting source and the shadows are like your main focus in a scene, where you're gonna put the light to create the shadows, to create this kind of contrast on the scene too. So all these kind of skills are very important, and that's one of the best, how to say that, one of the skill like you'll be able to put more than all the other departments. So you're also responsible to quality check. So when I mean quality check, is because you're on the bottleneck of the 3D. You're gonna have to be the guy taking responsibility to render what's gonna happen. So in some studios, you have resources to try 1, 2, 3 times. But sometimes some changes need to be done for the next day, and more the responsibility you have, and more you have to be sure about what you're gonna deliver, what you're gonna put on the farm and render. So there is all the artistic parts about checking what's happened, but also checking like proper issues, like maybe animation cache, maybe the model not work in some areas, in some part. So you're gonna be like the checking moment of the production. So having a knowledge of texture, look dev and compositing is very nice to be able to slap comp your lighting, to understand what you can be, what you can do with all your AOVs, your paths. You know, you're gonna like separate the image in multiple layers, and you can play with in compositing to be able to have more freedom and liberty on the like final image. So that's very important to have those skills. For me, I feel like a good lighting artist, like every department, have to be a good generalist in terms of his lighting everything on the scene, so you have to understand everything happening, so you have to be able to read the caches, read the textures, the look, and to understand what is gonna deliver to compositing, to don't lose this kind of week of render or these 2-3 nights of render, like can be precious in a production and is a proper waste of money in many studios. And more the studio is little, and more you have this kind of responsibility of overall package. When I say package, overall pipeline and process. If not, if it's a big studio, you're just gonna focus in lighting, and normally you don't gonna have to back yourself in other departments to fix your scene. So the renderer, a big question. when you're a lighting artist, the reality is you don't choose the renderer you use, it's the studio choosing that for yourself. For me, I use Redshift at home because it's fast, it's GPU, there is many reasons to use this as a guy alone working was for yourself. But in a studio, you want to be able to have knowledge in overall lighting. So let's say at some point you don't really care about what renderer you use, but more about the lighting and the aesthetics and the technique. It's not really a problem, but you need to fix some stuff at some point. When you like lighting TD, you're gonna have many technical problems to fix. So you need to understand what's behind the algorithm, behind the lighting in the renderer to be able to fix this. So we can name V-Ray, Arnold, Redshift, Renderman, Katana, there is many Guerrilla Render, there's a lot, Maxwell. So they have all specific, there is a lot of documentation in every renderer, so you can understand what's happened. What's gonna happen is the first one you choose is like you love this because you discover everything on this one and you want to stick on this one for the rest of your career, but you're gonna have to choose, and this is gonna be evolve a lot. In Houdini, there is a lot of mantra and it's very not artistic friendly, but it can look very nice because it's based on the software. So this kind of choose. So you're really close to art direction and computer graphic supervisor and VFX supervisor. So because you're gonna deliver, you have to check the image, the director in dailies have to be able to say, okay, I like this to put this in comp. If not, you don't gonna waste time putting this on the farm and spending thousands of dollars in just like something you're not gonna comp. So you want to be able, everybody is okay on this. So there is a lot of communication skills about understanding all the department agree what you're gonna deliver. Compositing have to be okay about what you're gonna do, and you're gonna find solution if it's not okay, and prepare like the deliver stage. So yeah, that's kind of everything I need to say on this lighting artist video. In my mentoring program, I use the lighting as the core of the program because I feel like you have to be able to do everything to have a good lighting scene. When you work alone on your scene, it's more easy to do your lighting because you know what asset you are providing to yourself. But in a studio, you're always gonna discover what's gonna happen, what they give to you. You're gonna have maybe some ethics to light. So depending of the cash, of the situation, a lot of questions, a lot of clarification before sending to the farm. So all this is something I'm talking in my mentoring program, and this is part of exercise when we're gonna model texture and look depth, but some shading. The lighting is like the moment just before the comp, and so that's core of this. So yeah, that's everything I need to say. If you have any question, don't hesitate to go on the Instagram and we can talk about lighting, about look, about everything. So yeah, that's what I need to say, and see you on the next video.